In our homes, at work, or on the move, for a century, the airwaves across Sydney have kept us informed and entertained. From dials to the digital age, Australian commercial radio is turning 100 this year. And to celebrate, we can now look back at a fascinating 10 decades on air.
From the lounge rooms of backyard tinkerers, Australian radio would first transmit 100 years ago. And it wasn't long before the live concerts and radio plays became requisite family listening.
And here it is. Stop him, Jill.
He jumped through the window. Are you all right, dear?
Yes, I'm okay.
The quiz show would also soon be a regular. One contestant, a young future Prime Minister in John Howard.
Hiya, John.
Not bad, thanks, Mr. Davey.
That's all right. What do you do for a living?
Oh, I still go to school.
Oh, you do? Yeah, what school?
Canterbury Boys High School.
Sport, finding a place on the dial early. Norman Banks calling VFL from outside the ground in the 1930s.
But he kicked it straight through the centre, and Carlton are still keeping their mind on the game.
With the arrival of television in the late 50s, radio found salvation in the booming ranks of teenagers.
420209 is the only number to ring in 3AK's chart check. And let's move it now with a sun raise.
At its ratings height, Sydney's 2SM would stage a stunt still talked about, promising a jumbo under the bridge and delivering.
One woman told me she got up at 3 o'clock, she thinks you're a rat in the fink.
The world's longest running radio serial, ending in the 70s.
The ABC presents episode 5000 of Blue Hills by Gwen Meredith.
In the 80s, the new stereo FM band added irreverence such as the Reverend Dr. Doug Mulray.
Reminds me of the story of the contortionist who died in his own arms.
And into the 21st century, radio is adamant that it plans to stay in our ears for another 100 years in the theatre of the mind.
A lot of people predicted that the rise of streaming and other services would mean the end of radio. In fact, the exact opposite has occurred.
There's no reason why that won't continue to be the case. I tell you what though, that only happens if we keep entertaining.
Mike Dalton, Nine News.